Hey guys, what's up? So today we're going to take a look at Genesee Specialty Honey Brown. This is a 24-ounce can, and it contains 4.5% alcohol by volume. And it says, crisp smooth lager, beer with honey, and with a hint of sweetness. And this is from the Genesee Brewing Company of Rochester, New York. Now, I know what you're thinking right now. Whoa, wait a minute. Genesee Specialty, isn't that Dundee's? What's going on here? Did Genesee come out with its own line? Is this like one of those things where it's Milwaukee's best and Old Milwaukee? Well, actually, no. The Genesee Brewery has recently rebranded their original Honey Brown as Genesee Specialty Honey Brown with a new can style. So what happened was the Genesee Brewery did away with the Dundee line a few years back. I do remember seeing it like a Christmas sampler pack, and I hadn't seen it for a long time, so I really didn't think much about it. And then come to find out that they've recently rebranded Honey Brown under the Genesee umbrella, removing original and removing any connection to the former Dundee line, which was a little confusing to me because I'm just so used to that old can style. Actually, Dundee's Honey Brown was actually, I think, one of the first beers I bought by myself after I turned 21. And I saw this and I thought, oh man, I hope they didn't mess with the recipe too much. I hope they didn't really change too much of anything. So that's why I decided to re-review this beer. I reviewed original Honey Brown around the time when I first started this channel. So if you want to check that out, review out, go right ahead. I'm sure it's a little bit shaky. But let's see if this has changed any. Well, first off, it's not as dark as it used to be. It's golden now. It used to be more of an amber color. Or my eyes are failing me, one of the two, but I'm pretty sure. It's got sweetness to it. I can definitely taste the honey, which is a good thing. It's got a pleasant flavor. It seems to me they didn't change much, if anything at all, except the color looks different. And that's a very good thing. Because, I mean, hey, you got something good going. I mean, why mess around with it, right? This beer wasn't very expensive. I got it at, where did I get it? I got it at the BP gas station in Rossford, Ohio. In fact, I think it was a Barney's, which was a convenience store that's connected with BP. And I think I got it for $1.29, and this was in Rossford, Ohio. So, not too bad. And Honey Brown has never been very expensive. It's like one of those, I've always referred to Honey Brown as a good beer that doesn't suck. And in this case, I would say that's very, very true. And I've also, for the most part, have liked Genesee beers. They're not very expensive, and they're nice tasting. Like the Cream Ale, for example, is a pretty good beer. So I'm happy to see that Genesee hasn't played around too much with the Honey Brown. Except I like the darker color better, but that's just me. But yeah, Honey Brown is still good. It's still you know, it's still worth buying. Really, my opinion has not changed on it at all. So just very good beer. If you haven't had it before, I do recommend trying it. So guys, that's going to do it for me. I want to thank you so much for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you have not done so already. And as always, guys, have a great rest of your day.